Liam Neeson? Nah. More like Liam Peeson. Liam Neeson is a professional actor who's been nominated for multiple BAFTAs and Golden Globe Awards. Liam being from Northern Ireland makes us country brothers. I myself am Gerry Adams' right-hand man, and I have been a proud member of the Irish Republican Army for 17 years. Just like Homer Simpson and Dwayne Johnson, Liam Neeson has also been predicting things about me for years.
I am not going to subscribe to Poker Bear.
But if you don't, I will look for you. I will find you. And I will kill you.
I really couldn't think of anything else. But yeah, if you don't subscribe and help me reach my goal of 1 million by the end of 2021, Liam Neeson is going to John Cena prank call your mum and dad, telling them to subscribe to Poker Bear until you do. Since the population of Northern Ireland is relatively small, everyone knows everyone, and it just happens that me and Liam go to the pub every Friday, and when Liam drinks, he drinks. I once seen Liam Neeson take down 50 shots of vodka in 5 seconds, and he drinks comic... and he drinks German craft beer from comically large wooden barrels, like this one from Shrek. And as a result of this, Liam regularly pisses himself when we go out.
Say cheese.
Cheese. Liam, if you piss yourself again, oh for fuck's sake, you dirty bastard. Liam has PTSD, which is also known as piss traumatic stress disorder. His addiction to pissing himself has actually became a runny joke down at the pub, and we all have our own. Liam has his piss. Ewan McGregor, or Biggie as we call him, has his crippling cocaine addiction. Samuel L. Jackson is addicted to having a lisp. Big Man Yoda has his addiction to painkillers because he's that old.
Doing painkillers in the shed, I will. Wife and kids will not find out.
And of course, I have been to jail multiple times for first degree murder. Making jokes about it is the way that Liam deals with his addiction. So I decided to write him a song because music is a universal language. This song has actually taken me a few weeks to complete, so I hope he enjoys it. Hello Liam, I've been meaning to ask you a question about this. Did you know that you're covered in piss? A huge stain spot around your crotch. Recently it's been happening quite a lot. Maybe it's because you got that boycott. Liam, you disgust me because you're covered in pee. Liam Neeson, more like Liam Peeson. Why is your dick a piss water gun? 69 years of age, get your life on the right page and stop pissing yourself. Liam Peeson, Liam Peeson, Liam Peeson, Liam Peeson, Liam Peeson. Thank you everyone, thank you again, I'm the absolute best singer ever. Not these guys.
Stop! Put your hands where I can see them. You stole copyrighted material. We must cancel you on Twitter now.
Listen, before you cancel me, just look at this. I got receipts, sister, and I'ma tweet this shit, give me 1 second. You are fucking finished. I am now leaving. I cannot go to prison again. Not after last time. I need to show this song to my good friend. Liam, I've been meaning to ask you a question about this. Did you know that you're covered in piss? Did you like it, Mr. Pete? I mean, Neeson. Mr. Neeson. You're crying? But why? Anybody, are you okay? And it was at that moment where Liam's piss traumatic stress disorder kicked in. Liam sat me down and he told me why he pisses himself. The reason why is not just a drunk mistake. It goes much, much deeper than that. Thinking back to one guy.
Family guy. Oh! Ground. Ah, damn it.
In an effort to please Liam Neeson, Peter Griffin, aka Seth MacFarlane, would give Liam Neeson foot rubs on the set of Taken because he was constantly running after the people who kidnapped his daughter. MacFarlane's goal here was to befriend Neeson and hopefully cast him in his upcoming movie Ted 2. After a few weeks of rubbing his feet, Seth began to get annoyed that he hadn't had anything in return yet. When he confronted Liam about this, Liam took offense and they had a brawl. Although in their first interaction, Liam had come out on top, the defeat gave Seth hunger to get revenge against Neeson.
There we go. Thanks a lot. Come again.
Do you remember the one scene in Ted 2 where Liam Neeson buys a
box of tricks?
Which is a scene that is presented to the audience as funny, haha, serious man buy child cereal. But if you didn't stay for the after credits scene, you wouldn't have seen Liam Neeson come back to the same shop in a bloodied mess holding the same box of cereal. And I wouldn't blame you, because everyone only stays for Marvel films. Like, look at this. This is how a cinema looks when the Infinity War credits are playing, and for any other movie that is not Marvel, this is what it looks like. And Seth MacFarlane knew this, so he felt comfortable putting it in there, but Seth does not know that I've watched the film Space Chimps 7,000 times, meaning that I know a good film when I see one. Seth had not only hidden this scene from the casual viewer, but he had also hidden himself in the form of a disguise, taking the form of Ted so Liam wouldn't recognize Peter Griffin and kick the shit out of him. Well, if Liam didn't consent to appearing in Ted 2, then how did this scene even happen? After the events of Family Guy, MacFarlane began to follow Liam Neeson, plotting his revenge. This venture ended up taking MacFarlane and Neeson to Boston, where Liam Neeson lives. Boston holds a 22.8% Irish population, making it the perfect place for Liam to feel like he's at home when he's away from home. As a result of this, Ted 2 ended up actually being filmed in Boston, and MacFarlane got a job in the supermarket that Liam regularly went to. MacFarlane's bear disguise was that engaging and haha funny that Neeson did not notice the on-location camera crew, as you can see here with Liam making continuous direct eye contact with Ted. What our main focus should be here is how Liam seems strangely persistent when inquiring if the trick cereal is
exclusively for children.
And given that MacFarlane spent several weeks rubbing Neeson's feet, we can automatically assume that MacFarlane got to know Neeson on a more personal level. The biggest takeaway from this scene is that Ted seems to be behind the tricks attack, but why would he choose cereal to target Liam? But more importantly, why would Liam question the legitimacy of the cereal's advertisement? There's just so many fucking questions, I'm gonna fucking lose my mind! You may have noticed, when Liam was at the shop, he was alone. But why? Tragically, in 2009, his wife Natasha Richardson died in a skiing accident. Much like Yuri Gagarin's death, the details on what actually happened were very scarce. They just kind of gave a general idea of what happened. And when we investigated Gagarin's, we found the truth. And I have some questions I need answered. There's only one man I know who has all the answers.
Your waistline's a little bit too thick.
What the fuck, you call me fat? Listen, I may have put on 267.2 kilos in the last 7 days, but I am not fucking fat, okay? Bradley, why the fuck are you laughing? I thought you were meant to be nice. You know, I'm going on a run, I'll be back in a minute. Okay, now that I'm back and 50 stone lighter, let's play the chase. Ah, look who it is, it's Big Mark. Ah, you fat cunt, you fat cunt. Ah, look how big you are. I beat the fuck out of you, mate. You're fat as fuck. Fuck. You're going? Seriously? Look who decided to come back. I'm looking at my cash prize of a fiver, so can we get on with this, please? I've got places to be.
The correct answer is... ...one of you. It is
Brad.
Over.
Bradley, what does it mean? What does this mean? Bradley, please tell me. Bradley, please! I spent multiple weeks pondering as to why I was never gave the correct answer that day. Was I not good enough? Did Bradley Walsh not think I was cute? And then I turned to what's most therapeutic for me, and that's making cereal. Ah yes, yummy microwaved milk in first cereal, just the way I like it. I started to think that I would never get the answer, but then one day, it hit me. Frosties? Oh my god, Tony and Tiger killed Liam Neeson's wife! And in that moment, I, Pogger Bear, Potty, DeMarcus, Epic Swagman III, realized that skiing was simply a metaphor to hide the truth. Why would Tony and the Tricks Bunny do such a horrible thing? As MacFarlane said himself,
well, I mean, they say tricks are for kids in the commercials.
Uh-huh. Generally, cereal companies like to use animated mascots to help target children. These children will be unable to comprehend the satanic background of the cute Cocoa Pops monkey, the yellow honey monster, and the Nesquik bunny who somehow profits off of selling rabbit shit on the global scale. As you can see here, Trix is back, this time with 6 fruity colours. If we analyse this box like it's a 2014 Illuminati video, we can take the number 6 being red as a hint of Satanism, and the 3 lines of text as the numbers 666. As shown here, only one adult ever has bought a box of Trix, and that adult was Liam Neeson, and he paid the consequences for buying a cereal that was
exclusively for children.
By sheer coincidence, Tony the Tiger and the Trix Bunny have also featured in several Family Guy episodes. Seth MacFarlane is an evil, evil man. He killed Liam's wife in hopes that Liam would make a film and Seth would just happen to get on the set of it. Even the film they worked on was a hint at the death of Liam's wife, with the film name Taken referencing Liam's wife being taken from him. Since then, Neeson has become more and more infrequent with his movie roles, with more of his recent movie names being slightly concerning. Since Ted 2 in 2015, Liam has starred in movies such as A Monster Calls, with that monster being Seth MacFarlane. He has also starred in The Huntsman, with The Huntsman again being Seth MacFarlane. Men in Black, which hints at Seth's attempts to wipe Neeson's memory so he can't tell anyone, and ironically, Liam has a movie called Memory which is coming out very soon. He is also featured in the film Nature is Speaking, which is a metaphor for the primal instincts of tigers and the violent murder of his wife. And finally, the film Cold Pursuit, which is a reference to MacFarlane following Liam to Boston. Holy shit, I have gone brain dead making this. So in conclusion, can someone just buy Liam a pair of nappies? He keeps fucking shitting and pissing everywhere. Liam, oh you, Liam, oh I'm gonna fucking kill you. Hello everyone, it's your friendly neighborhood Poker Bear here, and I'm just checking in on you to see if you get 8 hours of sleep and you've drank 10 liters of water today at a minimum. I personally, however, haven't, because all I've had today is 6 motherboard screws and a mini ITX case. I wanted to come on and give a genuine thank you for 100 subscribers that is not a mediocre attempt at singing Aerosmith, and from the bottom of my bear heart, thank you very much, you're all epic. I thought when I was making this video that I'd just be thanking everyone for 100 subs, but no. We've hit 241 subs, and I was on 100 last Saturday. I can't really comprehend it, but thank you. And yet again, thank you to Mr. Frog. I don't know why this video is still getting views. It is fucking terrible. Now that my estimated yearly earnings are up to 1,600, I'm gonna have to pay myself even more and more, and I'm in so much fucking debt. So can someone please buy Liam Neeson nappies, because I can't afford it. Please subscribe to my good friends, the Twitter police, and Crack Yoda. But anyways, I hope you enjoyed the video. Please subscribe so we can hit 1 million subscribers before the end of 2021. And because I made this video, Liam Neeson, I hope you don't get me taken into custody. Not again, I can't go back to prison.